So, welcome once again. We are going to discuss today procedure of issue of shares. Procedure of issue of shares. Now, I have already discussed this, but that was a part of this discussion, and I am going to discuss this in detail today. By the way, I am Moringam Ghosh, and my VTC code is 1064. So, as of now, procedure of issue of shares. What are these? The face value of a share is the par value of the share. Remember this. Face value of the share is the par value of the share. It is also known as the nominal value. So face value, par value or nominal value are the same. There are different ways of issue of shares which may be for consideration other than cash and B for cash. Now, in my previous class, I have already discussed this part, for cash part. I have discussed this. Remember that bank account debit to share application account, share application account debit to equity share capital account. In my previous class, I have discussed this. Now, I am going to discuss today for consideration other than cash. So, issue of shares for consideration other than cash. Sometimes shares are issued to the promoters of the company in lieu of the services provided by them during the incorporation of the company. The issue price of these shares is normally debited to goodwill account, and the journal entry is goodwill account debit to share capital. So, these are the shares which are issued to the promoters of the company. Promoters provide service for the promotion of the company during the incorporation of the company, and thereafter as a price these are paid to them. The journal entry is goodwill account debit to share capital account. In case a company does not have sufficient funds for the purchase of fixed assets or for payment to creditors, it may offer and allot its share to the vendors and creditors in lieu of cash. Any allotment of shares against which cash is not to be received is called issue of shares for consideration other than cash. So what does it say is, if a company does not have sufficient funds for purchase of fixed assets or payment of to the creditors, it may offer and allot its shares to the vendors or creditors in lieu of cash, and such type of cash is called issue of shares for consideration other than cash. Now, I will give you an example. For example, building is purchased and payment is made by issuing shares. See, a company purchases building and payment is made by issuing shares. In case of purchase of assets like building, machinery, stock of material, etc., the following journal entry is made. A company may purchase lot of assets. It is not necessary that it should always pay by cash. It may be so that it has a deal with its vendors that they will not pay cash, rather they will pay through its equity shares. A company may purchase assets like building, machinery, stock of material, etc., and in such cases the journal entries would be asset account debit to vendors or creditors account. Narration is being asset purchased, and asset is the particular asset. So if it is building, it would be building account debit to vendors or creditors account. And next is, it has to be paid, so vendors or creditors account debit to share capital account. Weighing the issue of shares of rupees, the amount of share is fully paid up. So this is how shares are issued in consideration other than cash. So B part is issue of shares for cash. We have already discussed in our previous class. So as far as issue of shares is concerned and the journal entries are concerned, we have discussed all of them. So next day we will solve a problem. Thank you very much.